The first hurdle is out of the way. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is Draft Champions. The Cowboys got the season off on the right foot, but they definitely still have room for improvement as they take the field for the second time. Their opponents here, the Kansas City Chiefs.
The Chiefs setting up here for the kickoff. Sanders going to be deep here for the opening kick. We're underway here. McCourty's got it. And the tackle's made right around the 25-yard line. Chubb's a man who has certainly gotten better by the year. And can you believe it? Already 12 years in this league. Foster's in the backfield. Single back set. Will go Brown. Foster tackled down. That's going to be a pickup of three. It's a two tight end formation. Second down and seven. Shot going down the field. And it's knocked down. This defensive lineup is anchored by the 340-pound presence of defensive lineman Paul Soliai.
6'4", 340 pounds. And I'm telling you, you look at him, you think, oh, he weighs about 280 pounds. That's how in shape he is. Every defense needs inside presence, and Paul Soliai will give it to you. Johnson's one of those guys. If he drops a pass or makes a mistake on the field, he doesn't make excuses. He knows no matter what the circumstances are, if you get your hands on the football as a receiver in the NFL, everybody expects you to make the catch.
Austin's going to look for space now. That's a gain of 10. Manning's a man who has certainly gotten better by the year. And can you believe it? Already 12 years in this league.
Well, here we go. Another start for Eli Manning. This guy basically has not missed a snap in his NFL career. He has done a great job of avoiding taking big hits. And, of course, also he's won a couple Super Bowls, MVP in both.
The Chiefs lined up in the pistol. First down at the 32. Handoff by Manning. Tate's tackled down after a gain of 2. He is one of the best possession receivers in the league. Brian Hartline.
Yeah, he's an excellent route runner, and he's also very deceiving. He seems to always get behind the defense because he's smart and very crafty.
At the 34, 66 yards from pay dirt. Tate lines up as the single back here. The Chiefs have it at the 34. Picks up about 2.
Tate's a dangerous runner when you give him room to run, but there is no room this time. What a job by the defense. They bottle him up for a short gain.
That last play was a run. Third down coming up. Manning will take the snap from the shotgun. Surveys. There's a flag out.
Illegal forward pass. Offense.
There's a call we don't see all that often. An illegal forward pass.
Yeah, that's right. The quarterback that time was past the line of scrimmage. He lost his judgment where he was at on the football field. I can understand why. Trying to avoid so many hits. Didn't realize he crossed the line of scrimmage.
Sanders has got it now. He'll pick up 7 this time. The Cowboys will attempt to get a little something going here on offense. This game has come to a little bit of a halt as we've seen 2 punts in a row.
Well, what has to happen in a situation like this, Jim? You need the offensive coach to dial up the play, to give you something where it's going to catch the defense by surprise, and it's going to work. And it's not about you just making the play. It's about the coach designing a play that works easily for the athlete.
Foster takes his spot in the backfield. Bad shot, looking long. He caught it. That's his first reception today. First down following the long play. Back here to start quarter 2. We are deadlocked right now in a game that has seen its fair share of defense.
Yeah, it's kind of fun to watch, isn't it? I love defenses when they come out and they just establish the line of scrimmage and beat the offense up. That's what we've seen so far, and I think it's going to continue.
Foster in the backfield, single back set. And the second quarter is underway with this snap.
Hard to guard these tight ends now in the NFL. It really puts the defense in like a quandary. Do we use a big guy? Well, if the big guy's not fast enough. We use a small guy? Well, he's not big enough. They get pushed around. I don't know what you're going to do. Just make sure you're a good tackler after they catch it.
Two tight ends on the field here. Second down and 11. And there's a drop.
Good job that time by the secondary. They're in good position. They make the play, and it's an incomplete pass by the quarterback.
It'll be third down. A drop.
Well, the quarterback that time tried to squeeze it into tight coverage, but no can do. The coverage is too good, and the football falls incomplete.
And converts on the 3. And they grab the upper hand thanks to that successful field goal.
Nothing like getting that field goal attempt and then making it. That's when you like the kicker on your team. That way, big guy, come through in these moments and get his 3 points.
Offense will start their drive from about the 31. And we've reached the 2-minute warning. And now as we come back to the field, we're looking at a defense trying to maintain a lead going into the break. The Chiefs snap it at the 31. Atkins in his face and takes him down.
That's an excellent job by the defense. Just gets quick penetration in there, hits the quarterback, and gets the sack. That clock keeps moving. What a job by the defense in this situation.
The handoff to Benton Tate. Brought down at the 20. The Cowboys use a timeout here. We'll take a quick break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Now, looking at third down. An extra tight end on the field for this one. To the ground. And he's going to be tackled, and that's going to bring us to fourth down. And the defense will use one of its timeouts right here. The Chiefs will punt the football away. Sanders is going to take this one from the 28. Denard's there to take him down. That return's good for about 25.
Sanders, such a great athlete. You've got to find ways to get the football to him. Here's another way to get it to him. On a punt return, how explosive is he? Man, Barry, that's the answer.
The Cowboys put some points on the board on their previous possession, but it was just a field goal. They'll be looking to add some more right here.
Yeah, they will. And, you know, listen, you know, when you talk about touchdown drives, you have to kick a field goal. What does that mean? That means you failed on third down. Just not a good play on third down. They got to do better in that situation. If they do, that's going to lead to 7 points.
First and goal. And the quarterback gives it to Arian Foster.
Foster's never able to build up that power that he has as a running back when there's nowhere to go. Hey, there's nowhere to go. That's a short game.
Second and goal from the 5. Ball forcing it across for the touchdown. That touchdown figures to have them in a very comfortable spot heading into the halftime break.
Ooh, they are feeling good. There's no doubt about that. It's been a show of good offense here so far in the first half. And now what you got to do, halftime comes, you got to go in there and tell yourself to keep this going and keep the pressure on.
Austin's going to test the coverage here. Runs it out to about the 27 before he's taken down. Brooks is ready to lead this defense back into battle. He's been front and center in what's been a sensational effort from that unit throughout the first half.
You're right, Jim. He is front and center, and the offense is putting all their efforts into making sure he's not the reason why they're losing. But they forgot all the other guys around him. They're pretty good, too, and they are getting it done.
Quarters formation here for the defense. First down at the 22. That's dropped by Cooper, who couldn't bring it in. Failing to complete that one. So, second down here. The Cowboys come out in a dime package. Manning's going to take it from the gun. Scanning the field. Two hands on the football and has the catch. The Chiefs call a timeout. Their first. That long gain sets them up here on this play. Hartline's got the catch on the touch throw. The Chiefs will use a timeout here. They'll talk it over before running a play on first down.
Only 34 yards to the end zone.
Manning's lining up in the pistol. First down at the 34. Hartline's got it on a pass that had some heat from inside the red zone.
Good job by the offense here. Hustle up, get that football snap, conserve time, and most of all, conserve that timeout. Those are big down the stretch.
Should be an easy one here. And he converts here on the field goal try. Phil, how about the kick here before the intermission? What does that do for this team?
Well, Jim, I think it puts them in a good frame of mind. It was a good drive by the offense, so that's got to give them confidence. And anytime you're close going into halftime, you got to be happy about that.
And Arian Foster heading back out to the field now for this next drive. And he'll be hoping to get a little something going on this drive, Bill, because so far he hasn't contributed very much.
Well, the good news is they're winning. The bad news is they can't run the football. If they want to continue to win or to be winning when this thing is over, they got to pick up this run game.
And it falls incomplete. We've reached halftime, and we'll be sending it back to our studio and Larry Ridley as we continue with the NFL on EA Sports.
The second half is officially underway.
And Curley's going to run this one out. Able to move past the 20 and brought down at the 23. The Cowboys defense trying to crack down yet again on the opposition, leading through two quarters and leading the way for this team.
I like the way they played in the first half on the defensive side, so make sure you don't lose that thought process and that confidence that you gained in what you did in the first half, and go out there and attack this offense.
The Cowboys defense brings in an extra member of the secondary. They'll go nickel. First down at the 23. The defense gets the sack.
Quarterback was not alert that time. The corner comes on to blitz, gets to the quarterback, and takes it down.
Tate's taking the handoff. Gains 15. Third down on the way. Nothing drives a coach crazier than a false start penalty.
False start offense.
Third down after the penalty. The Chiefs have to get to the 33 for a first. Manning from the shotgun. Takes the hit and throws. All set to punt here. Sanders has got it on the return. And that's a gain of maybe 5. The Cowboys break huddle and show a jumbo look. Just a quick drop back. Scans the field. Comes down with no. The defender tips it out.
Got to give the defense a lot of credit there, don't you, Jim? They are all over the receivers, all over the field, nowhere to throw it, and it just results in an incompletion.
Here's the handoff. Oscar tackled down. He's averaged about 2 yards a carry on the day.
Foster's trying to be patient, but there is nowhere to run that time, and he only gets a short gain.
Foster's lined up in a single back formation. They'll run it here. He's brought down. That's going to bring up fourth down. The Cowboys have decided now to go for it on fourth down in a short yardage situation. The Cowboys will take the snap from the 40. Right back to him one more time.
Anytime you go forward on fourth down in the NFL, that's a big play. And when the game is close in the second half, it becomes a huge play. That was a wonderful job by the defense stopping them there on fourth down.
The Chiefs' offense is on the field, hoping to erase the memory of their last drive, which was completely unproductive, a quick three and out.
Yeah, it was. I don't know if they can erase this defense. This defense is pretty good. We saw that in the last drive, and they got good players, and they're pretty excited, so this is going to be tough on the offense.
So three quarters in the books, and you're watching the NFL on EA Sports. It's first down now, right around 3 minutes remaining in the game. This is a time where the quarterback has to manage the clock, has to be very careful, trailing, needing points to get back into this one.
When you get down in the red zone, the offensive coordinator's got to call a play that deceives the defense. Let's see if he can do it. His team is down. He needs a big play here.
Second down and 9. Amaro with the reception.
That picks up 11. That's reception number 2 for him.
Big first down by the offense that time. Here in the second half, they're losing a close game. And you get that first down, it just gives you confidence. It opens up the playbook, and it just gives you a better chance of going down the field and getting the score.
Now on first down, every snap crucial the rest of the way.
First and goal from the 9.
Throws it in the end zone. Touchdown.
There's still plenty of time left on that clock, but the offense finishes off the drive with the touchdown pass, and now it's going to be up to the defense to hold up and force overtime.
Yeah, it was an awesome job by the offense getting that touchdown, Jim, and you're right. The defense, they got to get psyched up here and come out and do their part and stop the opponent's offense.
The Cowboys are ready to run back this kick. Sanders running this one out. And he's met head on right there at the 20. The Cowboys are putting up a dominant performance on defense, but then again, so is the other side, as we have a big defensive struggle going on.
I think coming to this game, Jim, we thought both of these offenses might struggle against the defenses, and we were right. For once, I should say, because it has been rough. The defense is very aggressive all over the football, and it's just going to be tough to score here today.
For this play, they'll go with 2 tight ends.
Doesn't like what he sees on the defensive side, so he is changing the play to the receivers by giving him hand signals. There has been good pass protection from the quarterback all day long. He has not been sacked much, and he throws it there and gets another completion.
Schaub's back at it now, dropping back once again. Avant's got it on a pass, had some heat on it.
After the long game, let's see what they do here.
Looking at every option. Travis Kelce comes down with it. Kelce's marked down at the 34. The Chiefs in a tie game will call a timeout. They clearly want the ball back with a chance to do something. The Cowboys coming to the line still have all 3 of their timeouts here in the fourth quarter.
Tie game in this one. Fourth quarter is winding down.
And he's taken down, but not until he picks up the first. The Chiefs will, of course, call the timeout now to stop the clock. This next play comes from the 30. First down at the 30. Back to the ground now on first down. Foster tackled down. The Chiefs defense will stop the clock here with under 2 to go as they want to preserve the clock.
When we were in practice on Friday, Jim, this team was working on red zone offense all the time. Well, here they are. It's a tie game. We'll see if all that practice pays off.
Second down here. Cowboys call for a timeout. They want to talk it over on what should be coming up, the final play of the game. The Cowboys back on the field now. We'll have a second and long situation coming up. Tie game right now. The Cowboys lined up for what should be the deciding kick. It's been an unbelievable game to this point, and now they can win it right here.
I can only imagine how powerless the feeling must be when you've led the team down the field and now you turn it over to a kicker to decide the game.
Well, you've been around a kicker all year long. You've watched him in practice. His locker is right next to you. So you have confidence that he can get it done in a big moment like this, and he did.
Bill Sims and all the crew at EA Sports, Jim Nance saying so long for now.
I'm at a crossroads, lost hope and I lost quotes. My heart smokes for the fire that y'all to provoke. For the disbelievers, guess the game was missing the leader. Now they kissing my sneakers, lipstick on my Adidas. Word to the reverend, I'm running this like Russell Simmons. The game is a scrimmage, I'm stretching my muscle. It's blasphemous, blasphemous. Hazardous, hazardous, smash on they with this classic fash. Gave him the biz, you ain't even gotta ask if you do it to the casket dip. Believe it or not, legacy mean a lot. Feeling the reef for the top. Yard dreaming, I drop. Damn, high break. Free from the grave. Make prisoners up a Rikers Island. Think out the box. This couldn't have been predicted by the Myers. Wrestling with religion and science. Look at me.
Two down, one big one to go. I'm Larry Ridley, and you're tuned to Draft Champions. The Cowboys have run right through these first couple games. But as the stakes get bigger, the competition gets tougher. Their opponents here, the Atlanta Falcons.
And Ryan Succop is ready to get this one started. Falcons are ready to run back this kick. With that kick, we're underway. And Cruz has got a chance to return this one. And the tackle is made right around the 32-yard line. He's taken teams from Indianapolis and Denver to the Super Bowl. He's quarterback Peyton Manning.
There's really nothing negative you could say about Peyton Manning except that he's lost two Super Bowls. He's won one. But the numbers he puts up every year, individual statistics, but also, let's don't forget, how many games his teams win year in and year out.
The Falcons from the 32. And straight ahead, Lacy. That's a gain of 7.
Eddie Lacy is the type of runner. You like to get him involved early, get him into the game. Why? Because he runs with such power, and he can punish defenses. If you let him do that early, I promise you, you get great rewards later in the game.
The Falcons lined up, bunch formation. Second and 4. Hand off. Tackle's made, and that'll move the chains. That's a nice, powerful statement as they establish the run at the beginning of this game.
Now, Jim, you're right. I'm going to give the offense a little credit here, but... you know, somewhere, I don't know, maybe the defense will have to put some weights in their pockets. You got to hang in there and make the tackle.
First down at the 43. Still on his feet. Now they take the football onto the opponent's side of the field.
Well, he's in the NFL because of this, because this guy can break tackles. Good job on that play.
Second and short following the run. The Cowboys go with the dime formation here on defense. Back to the ground. Spencer's all over that offense and brings him down.
The Falcons offensive coordinator, he has to be frustrated by that play. I think he calls the right play, but what happens to run loses yards, that's just a bad job on the offensive line.
Falcons come out with a split backfield. Third and five. Stiff arms to stay on his feet. Able to reach up and grab it. Gonna take it home for the touchdown. They take the lead here late in the first quarter with the touchdown.
Yeah, nothing like it. Before that first quarter was up, they found a way to get in the end zone and get that score to take the lead. And, hey, that's a good feeling.
Colston's going to watch now as his defense gets ready to come into the game. He just put up over 50 yards receiving, helping his team go down the field for the score. Spins away from contact. Runs it out to about the 27 before he's taken down. Out of the University of Virginia, quarterback Matt Schaub. The Cowboys approach the line and they're going with their jumbo package.
Foster.
That gains a few. It's now second down and seven after the 3-yard rush. Foster in the backfield, single back set. Stands in the pocket. Schaub's unable to find his target that time. Let's take a quick look at this defense. A second round pick out of Miami in 2008, defensive end Calais Campbell.
Well, if you give that defense a quick look, I'll tell you, Calais Campbell will get your attention. He is such a big man and has a lot of talent. He is the cornerstone of any defense he's on.
The Falcons with a nickel look here on defense. Third and seven. Avant makes the catch. The Cowboys still possess the football as we begin the second quarter. And the second quarter is underway with this snap. Has the first down. Now looking for more. Good gainer there by Foster. First down here after the run. Let's see how they back up the big play here. They'll run with it again. Foster tackled down, but not until it was a gain of five on the play. Double tight end formation. Makes the catch. Touchdown. The second quarter just barely underway. And they've erased the deficit and tied things with that touchdown.
Yeah, Jim, this kind of reminds me of a chess match. It's a good job going out there tying things up. Now we'll see the strategy from the other team.
The Falcons in kick return formation. And Cruz has got it on the return. And the tackle is made right around the 26-yard line. The Falcons offense preparing to get this drive underway. The last possession ended in a touchdown. Phil, let's see if they can do it again.
Very well done. Love what I saw out there on the offense the last time. They mixed it up and they showed a lot of confidence. You can see the speed of the football team and try to duplicate what they just did.
First down at the 26. That's McCourty making the stop.
Nice run that time. When you run the football like this, over a period of time, it's going to wear that defense out. There's no doubt about it. Nice job by the offensive line.
We've hit the 2-minute warning here in the first half. Glad to have you back as we come out of the 2-minute warning here in the first half. At the 34, 66 yards from pay dirt. Manning's lined up, empty backfield.
A little jumpy there by that defensive front.
Encroachment defense. Automatic first down.
They come to the line of scrimmage. First down.
Looks like a false start penalty.
False start, offense.
At the 34, 66 yards from pay dirt.
First and 15. Vernon Davis hauls it in.
Key to being a really good route runner and running these drag routes across the field is show some courage. Don't worry about what's in front of you. The quarterback will take care of that.
The Falcons have it at the 39. To Davis. The tackle is made and the first down is picked up. First down, offense readying for the snap. It's all about decision-making now as they work out of the hurry-up offense.
Yeah, it's really up to the quarterback. Make sure they watch the clock, don't get a sack, and don't get tackled in bounds. Make sure you give the message to all your teammates.
Second down after the incompletion. Standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. Davis going to pull in the bullet pass. That's his third catch of the day.
Nice job that time by the tight end. Makes the catch, and you got to look out for him now in the NFL. Remember, they're usually the closest receiver to the quarterback. Quarterback gets in trouble, he's going to look for the tight end.
Here's the first snap after the big play. Manning from the gun. And the catch is made by Colston. That's McCourty making the stop. Falcons signal for a timeout. They have two remaining. Play number six coming up on this drive. This play set up by the long gainer. The old counter play. Power surge for six. Touchdown. Phil, they have the lead now here late in the second thanks to that touchdown, and they should have it, in fact, when we go to the intermission.
Oh, now you see in the future, huh? So you know those things. I'm just kidding, of course, Jim. Like to have a little fun with you every once in a while. But, hey, nice drive by the offense. That puts them in a great frame of mind going into halftime here soon.
The Cowboys are ready to run back this kick. Sanders has got it. Just across the 20 and tackled at the 21. The defense comes back onto the field for this next series, and man, if they set the pace for this game so far, as their side has the lead.
Yeah, listen, I like what they're doing, and what's making this work is the fact that they just don't miss tackles. When they have an opportunity, they take the offensive player down. What a good job by the defensive back that time. That ball was thrown beautifully down the field. High arcing throw, but the defensive back in great position knocks it down.
Second down and 10. Jason Avant on the receiving end.
Good job that time by the ball carrier, picking up what he can, and he is very smart. Gets out of bounds and stops the clock.
That was a big gainer. Now it's time to back it up. Can't hold on here as this goes incomplete.
That incompletion by the quarterback, hey, I give the quarterback no fault. That was just tremendous coverage by the secondary player. He's in position and able to make the football be incomplete.
The Cowboys have it at the 44. Looking long. He rips it right out of the the wide receiver's hands.
Well, I think it's important for the defense. Anytime it's a third and long situation for the offense, to know where those first down markers are, give a little ground, and make sure you're able to come up and make the tackle short of the first down marker.
Third down and 10. Moore with the catch. Now they take the football onto the opponent's side of the field.
Set up now at the 42.
Get ready. Schaub's going to take the snap from the shotgun. Dominique Rogers-Cromartie makes that pickoff.
That was an awesome job by the defense. They just read the quarterback's eyes. They got in position, and they made the interception.
The Falcons ready to go on the march again, and that's exactly what they've been doing here lately. They've taken it all the way down the field over the last two possessions for touchdowns. Phil, can they make it three straight?
Let me say this to you, Jim. It's just not that easy. As we're watching this game and how they're playing on the offensive side, they make it look easy, but trust me, I was down there one time. It's a hard job.
We've reached the intermission, and soon we'll be sending you to Larry Ridley, who's going to break down all the first half highlights as we send it to Orlando in a moment. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. All right, Larry, thank you for all of those updates, and now the teams are coming back onto the field, and we're about to get the second half started. And it's the same as a touchback as he's tackled right at the 20. The Falcons defense heads onto the field here to start the second half, looking for another stop and once again to get the ball back to their offense as they're leading in this one here early third, Phil.
I like what they did in the first half. The defense goes in there at halftime. They get a little rest, so come out here and show that energy and take advantage of the situation and make some plays.
First and 10. Tackle made by Levy that time. It's now second down. No time to waste. They hurry to the line. Matt Schaub has it under center. And it's batted down. Third down and 6. Foster's lined up as the single back. He robs him of the intercept. Intercepted. Breaks free. He's brought down. Just out of the half, and they look to put points on the board to grab control of this game after the pick.
They have a chance to really change this football game entirely. If they go down and score, that puts so much pressure on the opponents, I don't think they can handle it.
The Falcons have it at the 29. And with no options, he goes ahead and throws it away. Second down coming up. The Cowboys defense now is going to go nickel, playing press coverage to the outside. Manning's got it in the gun. Fitzgerald's got it, and a first.
Keep the momentum on your side. You got a lead here in the second half. Nice play that time. You pick up the first down. Let's see if you can take advantage of it. Nice situation here for the offense. They're winning the football game. Now they're in the red zone. Let's see if they can come up with a play that fools the defense.
Makes the grab. Touchdown.
What a throw by the quarterback for a touchdown. It was just really nice. He threw it beautifully right on target. Touchdown.
The point after try is in the books. The Cowboys are ready to run back this kick. Sanders is going to test the coverage this time. Keeps his legs moving, and and he's on the sidelines out of bounds. That return's good for about 22. The Falcons have gotten a huge lift from their defense all game long here, and now well into the second half as well.
It always starts with defensive line play, just like an offensive line. When the defensive line plays well, that helps.
Kendricks chases him down. A lot of yardage to make up here after that sack. It's second down. Here's the handoff, and they'll run it. That's McCourty making the stop. Now third and four following the run. And the quarterback gives it to Arian Foster. That's McCourty making the stop. Foster in the backfield, single back set.
The quarterback's picked up on something. He's changing the play here.
And he reaches out and makes the catch. One-handed, no less. Let's see what they do on first down following that huge play. Dropping back three. And intercepted. Tackles made.
Mosley, such an impressive athlete. We know he can tackle and stop the run game, but how about that in the pass game? Defending the pass and picking it off. Good job.
The Falcons could have asked for this third quarter to have gone any better for them than it has so far, as they've just continued to do what they were doing in the first half, up and down the field.
Oh, man, they kept the pedal to the metal, man. They are letting it go. They're being aggressive, and they're trying to end this game right here.
The third quarter comes to a close, and you're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Falcons possess the football and try to take advantage of a big gainer right at the end of the third. It's first down now, right around 3 minutes remaining in the game. They bring in the extra tight end. He'll take the snap, the first here in the fourth quarter. Lacey takes the hit and is brought down. And the timeout is called, so we're going to take a quick break and return in just a moment. Second down. Plenty of defensive backs out on the field for this one. Adrian Peterson takes the football. And now they'll be on the other side of the 50 after this play.
Defense.
Third and five coming up. Looking across the middle. That's dropped by Colston, who couldn't bring it in.
Colston's unable to bring that pass in, Jim. He just took his eyes off the football. And when you do that, it's usually going to result in a drop. And those things happen. It's not a perfect game. You've got to overcome adversity. I think this guy will do it. Next time it comes his way, he'll make the catch.
No chance to return this one as that punt is headed to the sidelines. The Cowboys hope to get things going here. They have been anything but productive here in quite some time. Three consecutive drives that have led to nowhere.
Well, let's give a lot of credit to the defensive side, especially the defensive line. They are absolutely taking it to the offense. They are beating them up, and the defensive line is winning the battles like this. It's all about the defense.
Foster lined up in the backfield. Throws the pass. Unable to bring it in.
Got to give the secondary credit. In this passing league now, it's hard to make plays, but a good play there and another incomplete pass.
At the 22-yard line, here they come. Jobs lined up. Two tight ends set. Down the field.
The ball is jarred out of his hands.
In a situation like this, third ball, if you're the defense, catch them by surprise and blitz.
Following that incompletion, it sets up third and 10. Foster's lined up now as the running back behind the quarterback. Heaving it down the field. Offense back on the field here for this fourth and 10 play. The Falcons will come out in the dime. Schaub's back in shotgun formation. He'll throw it over the middle. The Cowboys turn the ball over on downs.
The Cowboys decided to go for it on fourth down that time, and it didn't pay off. And, of course, the coach, look at him now. He is second-guessing his decision.
As we see the stats now, you really like what both guys have been able to do at wideout today, Phil.
Yeah, they have been spectacular out there on the field. The numbers are awesome. This league, once again, we know it's about to pass, and we saw it here today.
Time enough to squeeze in one more play before the two-minute warning here in the fourth.
Neutral zone infraction.
The defense, a little jumpy right there.
First down.
Last play before the two-minute warning. The Falcons from the 27 gets the handle here. Just 2 minutes left in this one now. Back in a moment. We return out of the two-minute warning. Fourth quarter action. First down at the 38. Spencer's able to read that play and make the hit. That's a timeout by the D. That leads us to second down. Manning's got two tight ends on the field for this snap. Peterson's handed the football, coming out of the I formation. Picks up 8 here.
Always good to have these types of runs. Hey, it's not a first down, but it sends a message. It shows everybody that you can run it when you want to, and also it opens up so many other things for your offense.
Falcons have it at the 44. Forte's going to get it out of the eye. We'll set up now at midfield. Takes the knee. Phil, this was a tough loss to handle.
Yeah, it was. So much confidence coming into the game, thinking you had the game plan, your team was healthy, nothing can go wrong, and then it does. You make the mistakes and you lose. Tough to take.
So for Phil Simms and all the crew at EA Sports, Jim Nance saying so long for now.
Books. Don't forget about the great rewards you'll unlock for playing Draft Champions.
Electric. stay on tour and you're on bracket. Be in the hood, we are not being happy. Twerk that girl, this the one like the I'm your giddy. 90 B-boy keep the elements hot. Make them back spin the windmill. G-O-H, haters, a D-O-A. A young boy what I used to be. Now I'm all grown up, I'm a boss. Waving like that, come with me because...
Hot tracks and MTV. Now I synchronize the MPC. So this draft genuine like OMG, yo G, yum. Y'all in the booth like DB. LOL, old school, I'm so PC. See the mic, I gotta grab it, OCD. You're playing the odds when you face the mob. See the guard raising the ball, happy yards, don't get it. I'm hard in the paint when involved. And again, I might roll up in the tank, dog. Ain't no limit. G-O-H, haters get DDT. Is that same what they used to be? It's from Doc in the guard on board. Like a CP3, it's about time y'all get used to me. Because...
Sports coverage of the NFL is on the air. I'm your host, Larry Ridley, and this is Madden Ultimate Team. Coming up, we've got a good one in store between the Dallas Cowboys and the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. The Cowboys come into this challenge game knowing that they're in for a dogfight. And you can bet the coaching staff will be preaching all of the buzzwords, intensity, effort, execution. They'll need them all and more if they want to get out of here with a W. So now let's go to Arlington, Texas, where Jim and Phil have the call.
Murray's prepared to kick it away. The Cowboys are back deep, ready to return the kickoff. This game is underway.
And he's tackled right at about the 28-yard line.
Sims is heading out now. Now an experienced quarterback with 4 years under his belt. The Cowboys take it from the 28. And that's David in on the stop.
Here's a look at the offensive unit that needs to get off to a strong start today.
Bush takes his spot in the backfield. The Cowboys will take the snap from the 30.
Down the field. And it's incomplete.
As we focus now on this defensive lineup, take a look at defensive lineman Henry Melton out of the University of Texas, a big-time threat when he's healthy.
Yeah, you're always looking for a defensive lineman that can disrupt the offense from the inside. That's Henry Melton. He can get in the backfield, tackle players for a loss, and of course we have seen he knows how to get to the quarterback also. How about that? We just saw the fly route straight down the field by the receiver. Long throw by the quarterback and a nice completion.
The Cowboys come out. Jumbo package on the field.
Going for the home run. What a catch.
In the red zone. First down following the long play. Here's the handoff to Michael Bush. That's a gain of 6.
The Cowboys, they can do it all. Once they get in the red zone, they have the passes, the screens. They can throw it down to the back of the end zone. And how about that play? They can run the football right at you if they want to. And that time they picked up some good yards on that run. Bush is a dangerous runner when you give him room to run, but there is no room this time. What a job by the defense. They bottle him up for a short gain.
Michael Bush will run with it this time. Alexander's there to make the tackle.
Bush is looking for a place to run the football that time to pick up the third down and short, but nowhere to go. Offensive line gets dominated. Now it's fourth down.
That defensive front looks impenetrable here on the goal line.
And that's David in on the stop.
Starting at quarterback out of Florida State, the former Heisman Trophy winner, Jameis Winston.
Let's just go over the accolades. National championship, Heisman Trophy winner, first pick of the draft. Oh, my gosh, he's got it all. That's what the Tampa Bay Buccaneers hope. We'll see if he can get it done on the field.
Tough starting field position here. Press coverage all the way. And the immediate handoff to the fullback.
Jim, the defense just missed a big opportunity there. They got the offense backed up, and they let them pick up a big first down.
The Buccaneers on offense here to start the second quarter. It's first down, right around 3 minutes remaining in the second. And the second quarter is underway with this snap.
Good job of the defensive line standing in there and fighting, and they hold the running back to a short gain.
The Buccaneers at the line of scrimmage with their set of receivers in a bunch formation. Winston's going to take it from the gun. Surveys. And Murphy makes the catch. Williams there that time for the tackle.
Well, there's a lot of ways to get it done. Just remember, throw it to the open guy. You never know what's going to happen afterwards. Short pass that time turns into a long gain. Good job by the wide receiver.
First half winding down as we return from the 2-minute warning. quarters formation here for the defense. First down at the 37. They're setting up screen. And they advance the ball onto the other side of the field. So right into the hurry-up offense they go into this two-minute situation.
Yeah, these guys, all these pros, they've been doing this stuff since they were in high school running the two-minute offense, so I know they're ready for it. Well, we got a close game here right before half. Good job by the offense deciding to go into hurry-up offense. What you need here, as many plays as you can get and use up as little time as possible.
Well, every coordinator in the NFL has a box over there somewhere in that play sheet for third and long when he wants to try to pick the play up with a first down with a throw down the field. It can be seams, double moves, but they have four or five of those types of plays to pick up third and long situations.
The Cowboys are going to burn the first of their three timeouts right here. They're in punting formation. That punt sets up the defense now in excellent position as they're able to down the football inside the 10. The Buccaneers have been more than up to the challenge today defensively. We're nearing halftime, and they've allowed the opposing offense to get almost nothing positive going at all, Phil.
Well, you know what we got here? We got two teams on the offensive side. They can't wait to get to halftime to go in and make some adjustments, find some new plays, and try a different form of attack.
The defender able to knock it away.
That's a wonderful job that time by the secondary. Everybody's in position, nowhere for the quarterback to throw the football, and it leads to another incomplete pass.
It's a two tight end formation. Second and 10. The catch is made. Bryant's there to make the tackle. That long gain sets them up here on this play.
Quarterback likes what he sees out there outside. He's changing the play with the wide receiver.
Looking to go down the field here. In for the score, Dallas. That touchdown appears that it will secure them the halftime lead as the second quarter is winding down here.
Well, they sure hope it does. There's nothing like going in at halftime with the lead. You just feel like all the hard work you put in the week, you put it to good use, and you want to keep that lead going in at halftime.
Sims is resting on the sidelines as his defense will be coming out momentarily. He simply picked apart the secondary on that last scoring drive. He'll have a chance to take off. Gets out past the 20 and brought down at the 24. The Cowboys have to be pretty proud of their defense up to this point as we approach halftime, but then again, that could be said on the other side of the field too.
Yeah, that's what we're seeing, good defense. And listen, when you go in at halftime, you talk about what you're doing on offense. It's not necessarily the plays are bad. It's the order in which you are calling it. Catch the defense off guard. That's what play calling is about.
Final 30 seconds of the first half, and it's second down. The Cowboys lined up in the nickel. Second down and 5. Handoff made. Tackle's made, and the first down is picked up. The Buccaneers, one timeout remaining. Following that timeout, offense back out on the field. The Cowboys with two extra defensive backs in the dime. The Buccaneers from the 37. Incomplete.
That's what you expect in the NFL nowadays from the players, especially these receivers. They're so aggressive, so athletic. They go all out for every catch. That time, he just lets it all go. Not able to make the catch, but I'll give him an A for effort.
Second down and 10. Bobby Rainey makes the grab. Barrels ahead. It's wide open. Gains 11. The Buccaneers call a timeout here. They have zero timeouts remaining. First down and 10. Jackson's got it on a pass that had some heat. We'll close out the first half here in the Dallas-Fort Worth Metroplex. Time now for a short break, and we'll be back after halftime for the beginning of the third quarter.
Thanks, Jim. I'm Larry Ridley, and welcome to the EA Sports Halftime Report. The Cowboys want to continue to give their fans something to cheer about in the second half. The Buccaneers, on the other hand, want to quiet this crowd and turn things around. All right, let's roll those moving pictures. They have it at the 44-yard line. Sams is able to find his mark deep downfield, and that connection will lead to a gain of 44 yards. Buccaneers on second and 7. Murphy's by himself here, and he won't be brought down until he makes it to their own 37-yard line. Midway through the second quarter, Sims is going to find his mark, and that connection will lead to a gain of 44 yards. Same drive, Cunningham's got the reception, and that goes as a 47-yard touchdown. That takes the lead up to 7.
Okay, Larry, looking sharp back in that studio. Thank you for that. And now we're ready to get the third quarter underway as these teams take the field. And the tackle is made right around the 26-yard line. The Cowboys defense had a strong first half performance, and here they are to begin the third quarter, once again trying to make the stop and turn things over to their offensive unit, Phil.
Anytime you have a strong first half performance, what do you look for in the second half? You've got to be alert on the defensive side, look for something that's different, but more importantly, look for that trick play, maybe a flea flicker, a double move by a wide receiver. Don't get caught in a situation like this on the defensive side.
The Buccaneers will take the snap from the 30. Got a big lane. He's tackled right at the 36. He's averaging 5 yards per carry on the day.
When you run the football like this and you show toughness, there is no doubt when you fake it and try to throw the football down the field, the quarterback's going to have all day to get it done.
The Cowboys defense now loading up, expecting pass with a dime defense. Another carry here. That's a gain of 6.
Buccaneers look pretty confident out there on the field, don't they? And they're very calm, and they should be. That first down, they're right in this game. Don't look down the field for that big play. Just keep marching.
Now first and 10. Sims is handed the football. Now they take the football onto the opponent's side of the field. Coming to the line at the 45. Sims lined up as the single back. First and 10. Vincent Jackson has the reception. That little throw was good for only 3, so it's now second down and 7. The corners are going to meet the receivers right on the line of scrimmage. The give. They'll mark him. At the 40. On the way, third down. The Buccaneers need to get to the 35 to pick up a first. Winston standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. A nice grab. No doubt he was going to hold on to that one. Welcome back to this defensive showdown. They bring back out the offense to go for it. Time is running out here in the fourth, and the defense is trying to preserve this win.
He's able to come down with it. What a catch. One-handed.
The Buccaneers, good job that time moving the chains, picking up that first down. And, Jim, of course, there's no time to panic in a situation like this. I think they know that. It's in the second half. You're down just a few points. Just keep looking for ways to get another first down, and that'll serve your team well.
Gaines, 17. He's now over 50 yards rushing on the day.
Good job that time by the offense. They pick up a first down inside the 20-yard line. Now we'll see if they can punch it in and get 7 points.
2 minutes to go in the second half. Welcome back, and the defense trying to hold on to this lead with 2 minutes to go. First down, pressure on every snap now.
First and goal.
They want to keep feeding power surge. Touchdown. They run it across for the touchdown with the extra point to come that will tie it.
That's a nice job by the offense. So few teams now, Jim, can run the football in for touchdowns once they get in the red zone. It takes determination, a coach that has patience, and a lot of talent. They had it all.
So now we've got a tie game, but still enough time here to make something happen. The Cowboys have gone up top all day, Phil. Sims has been dropping back and airing it out.
He's had the time to air that football out, and what we are seeing, the speed of this offense. It's speed, what does it do? It can get down the field behind the defense, and they are making big plays.
The Cowboys will walk to the line of a tie game here in the fourth. The scores 7-7. Bush is going to secure the handoff. Second and 12. Scanning the field. What a catch. The Buccaneers in a tie game will call a timeout. They clearly want the ball back with a chance to do something. The line of scrimmage is the 17.
Now the offense is down here in the red zone or the green zone, if you like to think of money, and it's a tie game. A lot of things you can do. They love to throw it in the end zone, but maybe they'll cross them up with a run. We'll find out.
The Cowboys have saved all three of their timeouts for here in the fourth quarter. Second and 8. Right back to them once more. Bush is brought down after picking up only a yard. This is third down. The Buccaneers defense brings in an extra member of the secondary. They'll go nickel. And he's going to be tackled, and that's going to bring us to fourth down. They'll bring out the kicking team. A field goal try to take the lead here in the fourth quarter. Drives it through for the field goal. The Cowboys getting ready to kick it away. And he'll start his return. Gets out past the 20 and brought down at the 24. The Cowboys defense has put up an effort today that they'll be looking back on with great pride for many years to come, Phil.
Yeah, you know, Jim, it's so hard now to have a great defensive effort where you could just have so much success in the game because of the offensive foul power, because of the rules, everything, but it's been a great effort out here today.
They'll have to rush now as he's taken down.
Now on first down.
Every snap crucial the rest of the way.
Well, you go to the hurry-up offense for many reasons. One, you're trying to get as many plays off and use as little time on the clock as possible. That's what you have to do when you have no timeouts left.
Plenty of defensive backs out on the field for this one. The Buccaneers will take the snap from the 35. Scans the field. Mitchell nearly coming away with an interception. Huge third and long coming up, and they're certainly in four down territory as well. The Buccaneers will take the snap from the 35. Locked in on the football and has hold of it with two hands. The Buccaneers with probably their final chance coming up.
You are a quarterback. You like to put up points. But when you got to win in a low-scoring game, how did it feel?
Felt great, because when you're the quarterback of the NFL team, it's just like being the head coach. When it's over, everybody wants to know, what'd you do? Did you win or did you lose? Well, today we won a low-scoring one, but it still felt great.
For Phil Simms and all the crew, Jim Nantz saying so long.